A prime factorization is when you have a number and you factor it, and then you look at those individual factors and you see if they can be factored themselves. And you continually factor again and again and again, breaking these guys down into finer and finer pieces until all the factors cannot be broken down anymore. In other words, you break it down to a fundamental level where all the factors of a number are prime. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Let's say we add the number 12. You can pick any factorization of 12 to begin with. It doesn't matter. Let's say 6 times 2. Okay, 6 times 2 does give us 12, in fact. But now, when I look at 6 and 2, 2 is done. There's nothing more to do with 2. 2 is a prime number. You can't break 2 down into any smaller pieces. The only factors of 2 are 1 in itself. But 6, on the other hand, I think we can continue to work on 6. For example, we could break 6 down into 2 times 3 and then times the 2 that we already had. So 12 can be written as 2 times 3 times 2, or if you want to label them in increasing order, you can say 2 times 2 times 3. The order doesn't really matter. But sure enough, 2 times 3 is 6, and 6 times 2 gives you 12. These can't be broken down any farther. The 2, and the 3 are all prime. So this is 12's prime factorization. Now, earlier we were talking about how factorizations of numbers are not unique. You could factor 12 as 6 times 2, or 4 times 3, or 12 times 1. However, a prime factorization is always the same for a number. You can't have different prime factorizations for a number, because once you get it down to that root level, that base level, then you'll have all the same prime factors at the bottom. All right, now one tool that's really helpful for doing a prime factorization for numbers, especially big numbers, is something called a factor tree, and it works like this. If you have a number, let's take a bigger number like 24, and you want to find this prime factorization, then what you'll do is you'll break apart 24 into any product, and what product you start with doesn't matter. So when I think of 24, the first thing that comes to my mind is 2 times 12. So I'll put a 2 on one branch and I'll put a 12 on the other branch. Now, if any of your branches end in a prime number, you can stop and we'll circle it. So the 2 is done, there's nothing left to do. But the 12, on the other hand, you can continue to make another branch. For example, 12 is 2 times 6. This branch is done, we've ended at a prime number. And 6, on the other hand, is still composite. We can continue to break him down into, let's say, like 2 times 3. And if you keep going, I guarantee you will end somewhere. You will stop at some point. And so when we're done, we look at all the ends of the branches, and then we can write a prime factorization for your number no matter how big it is. So 24 would be 2 times 2 times 2 times 3. That's the prime factorization of 24. And let's do one last example. Before we do our last example, I forgot I was gonna show you something else. Earlier I made a comment that the order didn't matter. Let me show you that real quick. Here we started with 2 times 12. Let me start a different way. Let me do 6 times 4. 6 times 4, that's a different factorization. Well, 6 will break down into 2 times 3, both prime, and then 4 breaks down into 2 times 2, which is both prime. So notice this tree looks very different than this tree. They look very different. But at the end of the day, the prime factorization is 2 times 3 times 2 times 2. And the order doesn't really matter. You can see you get the same prime factors no matter how you start your tree off. All right, the last example I want to look at is a bigger example, and this is really going to show you where factor trees can really be helpful. 225, big number. You try to think of anything times anything that'll give you 225. The first thing that comes to my mind is I know that 15 times 15 gives me 225. You could also say 5 times blank gives you, what is it, 5 times... I guess it's 45. 5 times 45 would give you 225. Regardless of how you start your tree, continue to break these down into smaller branches, 3 times 5 and 3 times 5, eventually you'll get down to prime numbers. And then I think I have 3 times 5 times 3 times 5. So 225's prime factorization would be 3 times 3 times 5 times 5. So hopefully that factor tree will help you factor large numbers down into its prime factorization.